soon as I got out, I realized that my mother had not followed me out. And as I learned from the police officers, she had crawled over to where my father was and cradled him until the guy got back around to her, put the gun to her head. She looked up at him, put her head down, and he pulled the trigger. My parents had just had their 47th wedding anniversary. She wasn't going anywhere. As I mentioned, I'm not really mad at the guy that did this. And I'm certainly not mad at the guns that did this. They didn't walk in there by themselves and pull their own triggers. The guy that did it was a lunatic. That's like being mad at a rabid dog. I'm mad at my legislators for legislating me out of the right to protect myself and my family. I would much rather be sitting in jail with a felony offense on my head and have my parents alive. As far as these so-called assault weapons, you say that they don't have any defense use. You tell that to the guy that I saw on a videotape of the LA riots, standing up on his rooftop, protecting his property and his life from an entire mob with one of these so-called assault weapons. Tell me that he didn't have a legitimate self-defense use. Just one final statement. I've been sitting here getting more and more fed up with all of this talk about these pieces of machinery having no legitimate sporting purpose, no legitimate hunting purpose. People, that is not the point of the Second Amendment. The Second Amendment is not about duck hunting. And I know I'm not going to make very many friends saying this, but it's about our right, all of our rights, to be able to protect ourselves from all of you guys up there.
In fact, there's 20,000 gun laws on the books. And thanks to one of them in Texas that restricted carrying a concealed weapon, Susanna Hupp, well, let her tell her story.
Back in 1991, I was with my parents at a local restaurant. And we had just finished eating when a madman drove his truck through the window and very methodically began executing people. And he wasn't spraying bullets. He had complete control over the situation. He was simply walking from one person to the next, taking aim, pulling the trigger. My father ran at the man and was very easily taken out. My mother ended up staying with him. When the gunman got back,